Start.
Hello guys, I'm Prathamesh Sawant.
I'm Vishal Chivri.
I'm Prathamesh Vadharkar.
We the members of Team Ashwamedh are here to give a virtual presentation of our car design and manufacturing. Next slide. The technical specification of our car. The technical specification includes the engine. Which type of engine is used? Here we have used Bajaj Discovery 125 ST. Also, the maximum torque of this engine is 10.86 Nm at 5500 rpm. Also, the maximum power is 8.1 bhp at 8000 rpm. The vehicle dimensions of our car are here. The wheelbase is of 42 inches. The front track width is 36 inches. The rear track width is 38 inches, and the overall length of our car is 192 cm. The ground clearance is 2.54 cm. The total weight is 102 kg of our total vehicle. Let's see the transmission. In the transmission, the chain drive is used. Also, the top speed of our vehicle is 85 km/h. Also, in the chassis, the material used is special frame AISI 1018. That is the material specification. Also, in the steering system, rack and pinion is used, which is of 11 inches in length. The brakes are applied, and the stopping distance for brake is within the range of 5 meter respectively. Next slide. These are the views of our vehicle. As we see, in the center, there is an isometric view, and the four views are front view, rear view, top view and side view. Just look at the glance of these views, you have an idea how our car is totally about. Next slide. This is the design methodology. As we focus on the car, firstly what we have is that the position of our driver as well as engine. As we see, there is a rough sketch we made before, so that a blank idea can be made, and the sketch was designed on a rough sheet of 1:1 scale. Okay, then the PVC, with the help of PVC pipes, what we've done is that we kept the driver on them, and then the chassis was made. After that, each mounting of accessories were done, and finally the car, our car looks like that in that final sketch. The parameters here are the number of welds 47, and the tube outer diameter is 25.4 mm. The thickness of tube is 2 mm. As per the rule book, these specifications, that is the wheelbase, track weight, material use, material section and ground clearance, is given as per the rule. Next slide. As you see, this is the finite element analysis. In the finite element analysis, front impact, rear impact and side impact was a very important role. As you see, when the impact is carried out on our car, the three sides are given. But in front impact, rear impact, side impact, the weight is kept constant, that is 150 kg. Also, the time of impact is 0.2 seconds for each impact. Okay. Then the maximum force is 11.2 kN for each of them, but for side impact it is 4.5 kN. Also, the maximum equivalent stress plays an important role. But for rear impact it is maximum, that is 293.38. Also, for front impact it is 280, and for side impact it is 271 something. The maximum deformation is 4.5 mm. The maximum deformation for rear impact is 7.96, and for side impact it is 3.94. Okay. The factor of safety, also the factor of safety for each impact is different. Firstly, for front it is 1.31, for rear it is 1.26, and for side impact it is 1.86. Next slide. After the impact, there is also one phenomena called rollover. In rollover, the model analysis is kept, and as you see in that side figure, the roll analysis is given roughly. Also, the chart is there which shows the increment of the rollover. And in this graph, in this picture, we see the weight of vehicle. As said earlier, for all the impact, it is 150 constant, and time of impact is 0.2 seconds respectively. Also, maximum force is 1.62. As we see, there is a degradation, means less amount of maximum force is here in rollover than compared to the all impacts further. Also, the maximum factor of safety for this is 1.5, and maximum deformation is 3.5 mm. Next slide.
Next slide having steering system. We are using steering system of rack and pinion, and the rack length is 11 inches. Steering ratio is 7.1:1. We have Ackermann angle of 18.89. The inside steering angle is 39 degree and outside steering angle is 31 degree. We having turning circle radius is 1.94 meter and scrub radius is 128.84 mm. We kept the camber angle is 0 degree, kingpin inclination is 15 degree and caster angle is 7 degree. The self-aligned torque is 15.93 Newton meter. We also done the finite element analysis on knuckle and a screenshot is placed here. By this we getting the stub axle diameter is 20 mm and the stub axle length is 126 mm. The maximum deformation of knuckle is 0.8 mm and the factor of safety of knuckle is 1.5. We using the material for knuckle is steel 4140. Next slide. Braking system. We use the caliper and brake disc of Apache RTR 180. The disc outer diameter is 180 mm. Effective diameter is 171.8. The braking torque is 121.88 and the brake pressure is 18 bar. The caliper having Apache the caliper of Apache RTR 180 having area of caliper pistol 8.04 mm square and master cylinder of Apache RTR 180 diameter of pistol 19.5. The pedal ratio is 6:1 and the pedal force is 100. The stopping distance of our guard is 5 meter and the heat flux generated is 7,53,490 Newton meter. We also done the thermal analysis on disc. By this we get the outside temperature of disc having greater and than the inside. Also we done the finite element analysis on caliper mount and we place the screenshot placed here. Next slide. Next slide is having powertrain. We use the engine of Discovery 125 ST engine, which is having 5 manual gears, and the primary reduction is 3.08, the secondary reduction is 2.58, the maximum torque is 177.68 Newton meter. We use the chain for powertrain type 12B roller O-ring, which is having pitch of 15.87 mm. The velocity of chain is 9.8 meter per second. The power rating of chain is 35.5 kilowatt. We also get the number of teeth on driving sprocket is 14 and number of teeth on driven sprocket is 14. We use the shaft material is EN19 and the diameter of shaft is 32 mm. The maximum shear stress theory 31.26. The maximum the torsional rigidity for the shaft is 26.69 and the maximum bending moment for shaft is 370 Nm. We also use the bearing of self-aligning type. The load carrying capacity of self-aligning bearing is 5.59 kN. The bearing number of self-aligning is 6002. We also done the weight distribution of our card. Then we got the front side 42.85% and the rear side 57.50%. We also find the center of gravity of our card. Then we got the dimension of in x direction 609.68 and in y direction 0 and in z direction 405.7. The traction force is 1039.70. We also done the hub analysis and the sprocket analysis and the screenshot is placed here. Next slide. Next slide having cost estimate. The total cost of our card is 78,700. The individual costing is for braking 7,000, for steering 8,000, for miscellaneous 15,000, for bodywork 6,500, for VSMD 14,000, for engine and drivetrain 22,700, and for electric 1,000. The pie chart of our costing report is the screenshot of pie chart of costing report is placed here, and this chart shows the weight estimate of the of our card. The individual weighting of our card is placed here. And then the final weight of our card is 102 kg.
Next slide. Okay, the next slide is about the innovation. As we are using the pneumatic gear shifter during deciding the topic of innovation, the focus was on how to improve the top timing during the endurance test. Then we come to the bottom type gear shifter mechanism. This mechanism will reduce the time required to shift the gear and will also maintain the concentration of the driver over the race. Here is the pneumatic circuit diagram of the gear shifter. Also its principle is it works on the simple pneumatic circuit while the shifting of gears will be controlled by the motion of the actuator. Next slide.
The next letter about ergonomics and safety. It is the basic consideration in designing the cart. While the compact cockpit, which is comfortable yet safe, Ricardo seat used along the rubber dampers and neck support for comfort as well as lightness. In the case of aesthetics, the cart is so designed that every system is visible from outside, the well-balanced surfaces and the elegant curves to an impressive look. The safety equipment we use are SMI-rated fire suit, Snell certified helmet, cotton underclothing, round neck support. Also, our cart has certain features such as formula-style pedal box, detachable steering, bucket seat, and the central rear mount engine. Next slide. The next slide about the project plan. As we are doing a project, the plan is to be must to be prepared as per the requirement. So this is the slide of the project plan, in where the team formation is done at the basic initial stage, and afterwards the research is done, while also the design of steering, braking, and the exhaust is done. After that, the CAD modeling and analysis, prototype, and the final design and verification is done by our team members. Next slide. So the next slide is about design validation plan. In this, the components such as chassis and body, steering, wheels, and braking, and the parameters of their turning circle diameter, length of tie rods, steering arm length, tire pressure, stopping distance, and fatal report are undergone the test resource, and the proper images are taken by the team members. While the next slide is about, next slide please. The next slide is DFMEA. DFMEA is nothing but the design failure modes and the error analysis. In this, the components used are engine air intake, gear shifter, pedal, drive shaft, master cylinder, and electrical system. On these functions, the proper action are taken by the team members. Next slide. Thank you.